Okay. The history of apostolic succession. Apostolic succession. It's an unbroken chain. The validity and authority of the Christian ministry is derived from an unbroken chain of bishops back to the apostles and faithfulness to the message. The validity and authority of the Christian ministry is derived from its faithfulness to the word, witness, and service of the apostolic church of the New Testament times. Most importantly, the unbroken chain of bishops all the way back to the apostles. That's the most important point. And the formation of the episcopacy, the early church, we can see in the Bible, even in the Bible itself, we see that there was a beginning of a hierarchy in the New Testament church. James was the bishop in Jerusalem. John was a bishop in Asia Minor. Timothy, eventually, after being a pastor for so many years, became the bishop of Ephesus. Thomas went to India. He was the apostle in India, and he set up pastors and bishops there, right? So in the early church, we see that there was a hierarchy that began forming. Before the apostles died, they knew that they needed to create this new office of bishop in order for the apostolic authority to be transferred and be perpetuated into eternity, right? In the early church history, we see we have apostolic fathers. Most of these individuals here were raised up under the ministry of one of the early apostles. Okay? Ignatius was bishop of Antioch from 107 to 110. This is, you know, only 70 some odd years after Jesus died. Right? So Jesus died 33 AD. The apostles were all around up until at least 80 AD. And their sons in the ministry, so to speak, right, were the bishops that came along after they started dying off. Right. Ignatius was bishop of Antioch. Irenaeus was bishop of Lyons, which is modern-day France. Cyprian was bishop of Carthage. Clement was bishop of Rome. Who was the first bishop of Rome? Does anybody know?
Peter.
Peter was the first bishop of Rome.
Peter. And when Peter died, who took his place? Clement. So this tells us that Peter died somewhere around 87 or 88 AD.
St. Peter's.
Right? Polycarp, Bishop of Smyrna. We don't know when he started, but we know when he died. So these are the early church fathers. These are the individuals who were the original bishops after the apostles died.
No, I was just hearing me say this.
Now, here we go. In the Roman Empire, this is what happened. Around 300 AD, the bishops reserved to themselves area-wide concerns as opposed to individual churches. In the early church, the bishop was really just tied to one particular local church. But then as the ministries and churches grew, bishops started being over multiple ministries and multiple churches, right? And what happened in the Roman Empire, Emperor Constantine, when Christianity became the official religion of the Roman Empire in 313 AD, he gave bishop legal rights and authorities because the church and the government became one. And anytime the church and the government get mixed together, it's bad news.
Yeah.
Okay? That started the downfall of Christianity, 313 AD, when politics got involved in religion and religion got too involved in politics.
And do you think Constantine was really safe?
No.
That was my position. Okay.
Types of bishops.
He said no.
Two types of bishops. Diocesan and titular. A diocesan bishop has authority over a geographical area. Okay? Bishop of New York, Bishop of California, Bishop of Florida, regional bishop of this, state bishop of that. Okay? Geographical area. But then there's also titular bishops who are administrative. Bishop of Christian Education, Bishop of Bishops, Bishop of Senior Pastors, Bishop of Training and Development,
right,
Bishop of Covenant Partners, Bishop whatever. They're an administrative bishop, second presiding bishop, third presiding bishop, right? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So you can either be a bishop over a geographical area or a bishop over an administrative department, right? So you're either diocesan or titular. In the Full Gospel Baptist Church Fellowship, appointment to the holy office of episcopacy or bishop is solely in the hands of the international presiding bishop. He's the one who makes the call, okay? Unfortunately, in many churches and denominations, there seems to be a proliferation of the title bishop without any regard to the historic manner in which the office has been obtained in the past. Mm-hmm. Okay. Rights and powers of bishops, they're able to set things in order. They have jurisdiction, right? And what is jurisdiction? Two words, juris meaning legal, diction meaning speaking. They have jurisdiction. They have the right to speak legally. When a bishop says this is supposed to be a certain way, that's the word, that's the law. Why? Because they dictate legally. They have jurisdiction. They have teaching authority and they have legislative authority. In other words, they're able to correct and formulate doctrine, tell you what's right teaching, tell you what's wrong teaching. In the Full Gospel Baptist Church Fellowship, the bishop's authority is an extension of the international presiding bishop, and this authority never overrides the autonomy of the local church. Whatever influence the bishop may have is done solely through the office of the pastor. How? Voluntary submission. Okay? Factors in our use in the Full Gospel Baptist Church Fellowship, title bishop. Bishop Warren's personal history, he's a comes out of the Church of God in Christ, even though St. Stephen's was a traditional Baptist church, his roots are Kojic,
yes,
which had bishops, and is consistent with biblical terminology, as opposed to traditional Baptist. Claims to continuity, Roman continuity, established via the primacy of the Bishop of Rome, unbroken chain. Protestant continuity, Orthodox, Anglican, and Lutheran, all of them, all exiting bishops. In other words, if a bishop has been consecrated under apostolic succession, if they leave the fellowship that they've been consecrated under, they're still a bishop.
Okay.
It's kind of like the Calvinist version of salvation. Once saved, always saved. Once consecrated, always consecrated. So if you get consecrated legally and legitimately, even if you leave, you're still legit. Okay. All exiting bishops retain their consecration along with all the powers to ordain, consecrate, etc., and therefore also have an unbroken chain and are faithful to the apostolic message. Okay. Now, here we go. The most direct line of apostolic succession is that of the Roman Church, but the Full Gospel Baptist Church Fellowship can claim it from a variety of lineages. However, we also enjoy direct succession. Here's what happened. Okay. Pope Pius the 11th, I forget what his Italian name was, is Gubalacci Giugalassi or something like that, or whatever, something Italian, right? But he took on the name Pope Pius the 11th. Pope Pius the 11th was the Roman, the Bishop of Rome, because that's all the Pope is. He's just the Bishop of Rome, right? You realize that. But in the Roman Catholic Church, the Bishop of Rome is higher than all the other bishops. All the Pope is the Bishop of Rome. But in the Holy Roman Empire, when Constantine took over, he said, okay, if you're going to be the Bishop of Rome, you're going to be the Bishop of the Church, because Rome is the head of the empire. So if you're the Bishop of Rome, you're going to be the head of the Church. You're going to be over all the other bishops. Okay. So Pope Pius the 11th consecrated in 1924 Bishop Carlo Duarte Costa. In 1954, Bishop Carlo Duarte Costa consecrated Bishop Frederico Y. Duran. In 1990, Bishop Frederico Duran consecrated Bishop George Stallings. And in 1992, Bishop George Stallings consecrated Bishop Paul Sylvester Morton. Unbroken line, apostolic succession, Bishop Paul Morton was consecrated by Stallings, who had been consecrated by Duran, who had been consecrated by Costa, who had been consecrated by Pope Pius XI, who had been consecrated in the Roman Catholic Church all the way back to the Apostle Peter. Unbroken line of apostolic succession. You don't have authority unless you're under authority, and if you can't trace your authority back to one of the 12 apostles, you are an illegitimate bishop.